Children, a very good morning. So we dealt with the mountains and the plateaus. Today we are going to deal with the plains. When we say plain, what do we understand? We understand a low-lying area. So plain, plains can be defined as an extensive flat area of low altitude, which has a very low height, that is known as the plain. And when we talk about plain, the plains can be gently sloping topography, okay, gradually or gently sloping topography, and it has a very less altitude, we can say, above the sea level. It can be less than 150 meters above the sea level. So talking about the plains, the relief of the plain have sometimes isolated hills. Okay, when we say plains, it does not mean only an extensive plain area, but sometimes it does have isolated hills here and there. And the important characteristics of the plain is it's completely or nearly a leveled surface or leveled land area. And plains, they are very fertile, since plains are basically formed from the deposition of the silt and the sand. That's why it is considered to be a very fertile area. Since it is a fertile area, that's why it is a cultivated area. And since it is fertile, cultivated, that's why it has lots of settlement in it. And it is crisscrossed by various structures, like the infrastructural features like railways, roadways, industries can be seen in the plain region. Where the formation of the plains are concerned, so it is formed by both internal and external forces of the earth. And where external forces are concerned, both aggradation and degradation are responsible for the formation of the plains. And plains, they are found in all the latitude. It's not that certain latitudes are only the places where concentration of the plains are found. It is found in all the latitudes. Like, it can be found in the equatorial region, it can be found in the temperate region, it can be found in the polar region as well. So we can say that it is found in all the latitudes. It is also found near the sea coast. It is also found in the interior of the continent. So there is no hard and fast rule as to where the plains are found. We can bifurcate plains into different types, okay? That's according to the their situation, or where they are situated, or where they are located, or how they have been formed. That is the mode of origin. What is the mode of their origin? Plains can be divided into two types, that is the structural plain and the depositional plain. So we will explain this one by one. What exactly is a structural plain? It is formed by horizontally bedded rock. When the horizontally bedded rocks are there and they has not been disturbed by any kind of earth movement, those kind of plain is known as the structural plain. Apart from it, the plains that is formed due to the emergence of the sea bottom, or the seabed has emerged, because of it a formation of plain has taken place, that is also a structural plain. And this structural plain, which has formed because of the emergence of the sea bottom, it becomes very extensive if the coastal area is closer to the plains that has been formed. So that coastal area, it is adding to the extension of the structural plain that has been formed. Because of it, what has happened? The structural plain, it has become broader, and it becomes more broader towards the ocean. That's because of the deposition that occurs in the ocean area. There are various examples of the structural plain. Okay, first one is the Great Plain in Russian Platform. That is a very good example of the structural plain. Apart from it, the Great Plain of USA, the Central Lowland of Australia, are a result of the shape and arrangement of the original underlying rock, the formation of this Australian lowland has taken place. The coastal plain that is between the Arabian Sea and the Western Ghats, that is also an example of the structural plain that has been formed because of the emergence of the sea bottom. Now, let's talk about the depositional plain. So, depositional plains are formed when the material that has been brought down by the river, wind, stream, glacier, it is deposited. An extensive plain area is formed in a depression that is known as the depositional plain. According to what is the agent of erosion and in which places the deposition has taken place, depositional plain can be divided into various types. Okay, so to name some of the depositional plains are alluvial plain, drift or glacial plain, or and the next one we call it aeoline or wind or loess plain, lacustrine or river deposit. These are the various types of depositional plains. Let us talk about the alluvial plain. So this alluvial plain is formed by the gradual accumulation of the silt that has been brought down by the river down the mountain, and that water when it overflows and deposits the material that it has brought along with it, then different types of alluvial plains are formed. Pavement plains, okay, it is a type of alluvial plain. It is fan shaped, formed at the foothills. It's written GAN, it's supposed to be fan shaped, okay, and it is shaped like a fan and it is deposited at the foothills of the mountain. That is the pavement plain, and the shape or the size of the pavement depends on the amount of deposition that is taking place. Okay, if the deposition is more, then obviously the fan would be larger. If the deposition is less, the fan is smaller. Now the next one is the Barber Plain. It is deposited in the foothills in the form of belt. So it is similar to the pavement. Barber is similar to the pavement, but it is in the shape of a belt rather than in the shape of a fan. Then the third one is the flood plain, formed by the clay and silt that overflows during the flood. So during the flood, what happens is the river, it overflows on its bank. And when the river subsides, at that time, the sand and the silt is left behind. That brings about a creation of a plain that is known as the flood plain. The next one is the delta plain, formed at the mouth of the river. So when the river is about to throw its water into the lake or a sea or an ocean, then at that time lots of deposition takes place in the shape of a triangle. That is known as the delta plain. Most of the extensive alluvial plain, it is formed in the middle course of the river, and it is very fertile as well as level and flat land exist. So the example of this alluvial plain, it is in the northern China, that is the plain of Hongho and Yangtze Kang plain. Then in Indo-Gangetic plain in India also we have this type of alluvial plain. In Mississippi, there is Mississippi has created a plain that is the Mississippi plain, and Po Valley of Italy is also an example of the alluvial plain. We dealt with the first type of depositional plain, that is the alluvial plain. Now we will deal with the second type of depositional plain, that is the drift or glacial plain. Okay, so when the deposition is formed due to the glacier which melts, which is carrying lots of debris with it, then that plain, it is known as the glacial plain or the drift plain. So it is of extensive size and it has a very irregular surface. Unlike the alluvial plain, it has a very irregular surface because it has composition of various kinds of material, like huge boulders are there, as gravels are there, sands are there. So because of it, it has very irregular surface. we see a very good example of the drift or glacial deposit deposited plain is the Central North America and Western European plain. Aeolian plain is the third type of depositional plain, and it is also known as Lewis plain. It is also known as deposition by wind plain. So this plain, it is basically formed because of the deposition that occurs because of the wind. And this plain, it occurs in arid, or we can say a very dry area. Okay, the example of this Aeolian plain can be seen in North China, which covers more than 2.5 lakhs square kilometers of area, and the thickness of the sand that has been deposited is round about 3,000 meters, and it is also seen in Pampas of Argentina. Last of the depositional plains that we will be talking about is the lacustrine plain. So this lacustrine plain has been formed because of the filling up of the lake, okay, by the silt that has been brought by the river. So what is happening is, when the river, which is carrying loads of silt, it passes through a lake, at that time the river, which is very muddy when it is it has reached the lake, deposits all its sediment in the lake, and the river and the water that comes out from the other side of the lake, it is a clean water. So that means lots of silt has been deposited in the lake. So when this process goes on for a very long time, the lake, it gets filled up with the silt, and a plain land surface comes into existence. This plain land surface, it is the lacustrine plain. Some of the examples of the lacustrine plain is the plain that is in Hungary in Europe. Not only that, the plain that is surrounding the Great Lake of North America is also an example of lacustrine plain. Okay, this is all for today, girls. We will continue with the significance of the plains in the next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.